Hello students, in standard 11 I am going to teach you the subject economics. First chapter is economics and introduction. In this chapter you are going to understand regarding economic meaning, definitions, in ancient times how it has been derived, the activities such as economic activity, non-economic activity, how we are going to use the statistical data of in the part of economics, how we are going to form a diagram and graph, what are the importance of economics in our life. These all things you are going to understand in this chapter. So first, in introduction part, the individuals or human beings are surrounded by many things, so are making different groups. So they are classifying the various sectors, they are making the various groups. They are collecting the information in a such a way that is useful in various categories. So they have made different groups such as political, social and economic. Even in earlier days also, the individuals face complexities of the problems which they were facing in their life. For the solution, they were fighting or they were arranging the war with the rivals. So, but in this part, in the modern times, the people made use of certain philosophies or science. They have created some ethics, some principles, so they get the logical solution for that. So fighting is not the option for an individual. There are many ways, there are many principles the individual should learn to find out a proper and reasonable solution. So first of all, the meaning of economics. In Indian language, economics word is pronounced as Arthashastra. In Sanskrit, we can say as Arthashastra. Artha means a goal or purpose. So in Sanskrit, we can say that the meaning of Arthashastra is a benefit in the form of a science or in the philosophy in our practical life. We should have some faith. We should follow some scientific solution for finding a problem. These all things you are going to understand in this chapter. The word economics is derived from a Greek word, okinomos. Okios means they have specified the meaning of okinomos is household, and nomos means management. The individual or a human being is managing his household work. How he is in practical life, he is arranging the stuff. How is managing the activities? Suppose even you also are managing many things in your life. You are waking up in the morning and properly managing your schedule. Morning is I want to attend the classes or I want to go to school. At that time I will play, I will talk with my friends, I will study this time. You are managing the things. So even the individual, how is managing this household stuff? We can say that as a economics, okinomos. Economic in Indian thought. In economic thought, we can say that economics is divided into four parts. The full whole part we can know as the Purushastra, that is the purpose. So first point is dharma. First point is what? Dharma. We can say that as a duty, the individual's duty. What things he should perform in a day or in his life. The second part we can say that as a earth, the wealth or the benefit. The individual has some wealth in his life. We can say that the house, jewelry, that is his wealth. How he is making that? Third part is karma, that we can say that the desires, individual thinking, desire, goals. What he should do for achieving this part or that part. And fourth part is moksha, the peace in his life, the liberation. How he can survive his life in a peaceful manner. So fourth part of Purushastra, first is karma, second is artha, third is kama and fourth is moksha. Even 2005 years ago, Kautilya, you know as the Chanakya, he has specified in his book Arthashastra as the activity the individual or a human being is doing for the survival, for getting the benefit, for the wealth, for the peace, as known as the Arthashastra. Even the activity individual is performing in individual is to create wealth. How the individual is creating wealth for himself. Okay, thank you everyone.